Hey beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, then welcome. As you guys can see by the title of this video, TT is here to give some more tea about another product line, aka it's time for another product review, an honest one at that. But before we get into that, make sure you guys like this video, leave me a comment down below and let me know that you are here, and let's go. So guys, you already know that I wash my hair every week, and every week I am so excited to show my crown some extra love. But today I'll be using Eden Body Works, and if you guys know me, then you'll know Eden Body Works has been my go-to since about 2013-2014. That's when I really started my hair care journey. Well, my natural hair journey, I should say. And this is the first brand that I started using on a consistent basis because it's the only thing that was working for my hair, okay? So today I will be reviewing the Papaya Castor line. So this line has 5 different items in it. It has the scalp cleanser, the foam conditioner, which is a leave-in, the scalp massaging serum, and then it also has 2 styling products, which is the Nourishing Curl Jam and the conditioning hair dress. Now, I'll be honest, my first impression of this line was like, what's going on here? And I thought that because I saw the scalp cleanser and I thought it was a shampoo. You know, I just didn't read the label 100%. So I thought it was a shampoo and I'm like, okay, there's a shampoo, but there's no conditioner. Like, what's going on? And then I saw that there's a foaming conditioner. I'm like, okay, what's going on here? And then I got confused because, you know, there's 2 styling products and I didn't know what was going on. So either way, that was just my first impression, just a little bit of confusion, but that's just me not doing the research that I need to do and not reading the labels properly. So the scalp cleanser is not a shampoo. At least that's how I'm taking it. And I say that because it just says it's a gentle cleanser and that it exfoliates and nourishes the hair and scalp. So it doesn't say it's a shampoo. It doesn't say, you know, make sure you deep condition after or anything like that. So I'm assuming that this is like a co-wash. Okay. So it's like a conditioning co-wash, kind of like their coconut shea co-wash that they have. And if you guys are not hip to that, you need to go ahead and try that co-wash out because it is bomb.com. It will always be one of my favorite co-washes. But yeah, so this is the scalp cleanser. So it just says to apply to wet hair, lather on scalp, and then rinse it well. It has no mineral oils, no dyes, it's cruelty free, and it is made in the US. It also says it removes dirt buildup, balances hair and scalp pH. Y'all, I'm not even gonna try to read these ingredients today because it is so small and I don't have my glasses on right now. I really don't feel like wearing them. But you guys can see how small it is. I cannot strain my eyes right now, y'all. I will say the first thing says water and then I don't know how to say that alcohol, but it's acetyl alcohol and sterile alcohol. And I know that those 2 are actually good for our hair. So those are the first 3 ingredients, but I'm not gonna strain my eyes today. Then the next thing is the foam conditioner. And like I said, I was kind of like confused because I'm like, there's no conditioner and this is supposed to be conditioner, but you're not supposed to rinse it out. I should be smarter than this. Yes, I know. So the foam conditioner is actually a leave-in. So it says it reduces frizz, tames flyaways, and it says to generously apply on damp hair shaft down to the ends and do not rinse. Again, no mineral oils, no dyes, cruelty free, and it's made in the US. The first couple ingredients on this is water, hydrogenated castor oil, and glycerin. So I've never used, you know, a leave-in that's, you know, kind of like a mousse. So I'm kind of excited to see how this goes. So yeah, so this is the leave-in. Then we have the massaging serum. So on the back of this, it says apply lightly directly on the scalp, massage, and do not rinse. And it says it soothes the scalp using a vitamin blend of A, C, B, and E. It's hydrating and nourishing. And the first couple of ingredients on here is water, glycerin, polysorbate 20, I'm not sure what that is, and then sorbitol, cannot read it, y'all. But I'm not sure what those last two are, so I'll definitely insert that so you guys know and so that I learn something new. But yeah, so this is the massaging oil. And then we have the conditioning hairdress. And, you know, like I said, the nourishing curl jam. So this is where I got a little bit confused. So I'm gonna read the back of both of them. So on the conditioning hairdress, it says, styling hair balm to nourish and strengthen the hair shaft. It smooths the hair cuticle, adds shine to dull hair. And then the nourishing curl jam says, styling and conditioning moisturizing jelly for textured and or curly hair. Smooth, sleek, styling, light hold. So, I think the biggest difference is that this jam is just like, kind of like a gel. It says it's a light hold, so I'm assuming that there shouldn't be any crunch or anything like that. And I wanna say that this conditioning hairdress is probably kind of like a leave-in as well. I'm not 100% sure. But, you know, being that both of these are here, I'm not gonna use both of them when I do go to style my hair. I honestly think I'm gonna go ahead and use the conditioning hairdress only because I'm gonna be putting some twists in my hair and I'm gonna keep them in twists. So I just wanna make sure that my hair is nice and nourished, strengthened, and it has a lot of shine. Whereas if I was gonna do a twist out or a braid out, then I think I would use this because it has a light hold to it. So these are the items that are in Eden Body Works Papaya Castor line. I'm really excited to use them. They've been sitting on my shelf for a couple of weeks now. So I'm like, you know what, let me go ahead and give them a try. Dust it off a little bit and, you know, let it nourish my hair. So that's what we're gonna do, and I'll be back with my review. So I am back, and as you guys can see, my hair is freshly washed. First things first, I did not have a lot of shedding or anything like that from using this line. So this is how much I lost. It is not that much at all, and I am actually really surprised because, you know, I had my hair in two braids for a week. So I expected to lose a little bit more than that, but hey, I'm not complaining at all. But I just wanted to start off with that. I really didn't have much shedding. Okay, so let's go ahead and get into what I think about the Papaya Castor products. So first things first is the scalp cleanser. So y'all, this line smells delicious, okay? I've never had papaya, but I'm pretty sure this is what papaya smells like. Like, it is so sweet smelling. It's just soothing to the soul, and I'm so serious. Like, I smell really good right now, okay? I smell really good. My hair smells fantastic, so. But yeah, so it smells really good, and it is like a co-wash. It doesn't have any lather or anything like that that, you know, I'm showing you guys in the video. There's no lather or anything, which is okay by me. I'm not a big lather person. And I will say it kind of melted into my hair, so I did like that. The slip was really good. My hair detangled very well. So that's really good. I really like that, and I like this cleanser. Or I'm gonna call it a co-wash because that's just easier for me to say. So I really did appreciate this co-wash, and my scalp did feel clean and a little bit better once I used my scalp massager to kind of, you know, clean my scalp. So if I will do what I do, I would give this co-wash a 5 out of 5. Definitely would recommend it. It's not as good as the coconut shea co-wash though. I will say that, like, it's not beating that. But it is a close second to that one. Next is the scalp massaging serum. So I don't have too much to say about it because obviously I just put it on my scalp, But I will say it's a very smooth texture, so I do like that it's a smooth texture. The only thing I will say is it kind of felt like it was kind of foamy on my scalp. And when I used it a few weeks ago, I felt that way as well. And I just wasn't sure, you know, why, what it is. So there must be something in these products that kind of make it have that foamy feel. I don't necessarily think my hair actually was foaming or anything like that, but that's just kind of how it felt. So yeah, I don't have much to say about it other than it has a smooth texture. It smells really well. I'm gonna keep using this throughout this week on my scalp to see if I, you know, feel any differences or anything like that with it. But as of today, I would give this a 4.5. And that 0.5 mark off is literally just because of that foamy, sticky type feeling. I don't even know how to describe it, but that's all. So 4.5 for this. And then last but not least, the foam conditioner. So first thing about this, less is more, okay? A little goes a long way, okay? So on my very first section, I did 4 or 5 pumps. I should have did like 2 pumps and then added from there because my hair was just foaming at the mouth. Like it was just too much, okay? But yeah, it was less is more, y'all, less is more. But it was really different for me because obviously I've never used a leave-in that is a mousse type texture. You know, I do like the creams and whatnot. So putting it on my hair, I want to say that it went on my hair very well. But I don't think the slip was there how I expected it to be or how I wish it would have been. So that is the only downfall of this. You know, I'm just a cream kind of gal. My hair likes cream. That's just what it is. Leave-in creams. It doesn't like leave-in sprays. And now it doesn't like leave-in conditioner. But I will say, you know, if I do use this again, I think I would do this with a roller set or something, or maybe a flexi rod or something like that. I think this would be perfect for that. But as just a leave-in, I don't know, just like I said, the slip wasn't there. It didn't make my hair feel bad or anything like that. But again, I just wish it was a cream. It was thicker for my hair. That is all. It's not bad or anything like that. Little goes a long way, so I believe it'll last quite a while. And I will say it did define my hair. I do feel like it did define my curls. As you guys can see a little bit, got some definition going on everywhere. But if I wanted to rate this, I would give that a 4 out of 5 stars. I think it's a decent product. My opinion, my preference would be a leave-in cream. So my favorite leave-in cream actually is the Coconut Shea leave-in conditioner from Eden Body Works. Like my all-time fave will forever be my fave. It's been sold out on their website, fave, and I'm really upset, fave, because I need it back on my shelf, fave, okay? You feel me? But yeah, so I would give that a 4 out of 5. So just off of those 3 products, I would give them a total of a 4.5. Total of a 4.5, a 4, 4.5, and 5. I would give them a total of a 4.5 out of 5. So yes, I would recommend it. I just think the leave-in is just not for my hair type. That is all. So if you have hair type like me, I would say use their Coconut Shea leave-in conditioner because you will absolutely positively love it. As far as the Nourishing Curl Jam and the conditioning hair dress, while I am styling my hair, I will go ahead and rate those at the end of that. So stay tuned for that. But I appreciate you guys for sticking with me to the end. Let me know what you guys want to see next. Let me know what you guys think. And if you haven't done so already, make sure you click that subscribe button. And as always, I'll see you guys again very soon with another video. Bye.